Ridvan was formed in 2012 to provide faith communities with the opportunity to build relationships with one another, to build relationships with businesses, organisations and residents of Dublin. Dublin City Interfaith Forum Youth Board is hosting today's event, and here we have Irish representatives from Dublin-based faith communities who are coming together to problem solve issues relating to young people in Dublin. Over these 7 days, we have had faith communities coming together across Dublin and featuring in short events here in the Lord Mayor's Garden. The purpose of this series is to make up for missed events that the different faith communities have had over this unique year, and to celebrate our various religious holidays, holy days, and festivals which were impacted by COVID-19. On behalf of Dublin City Interfaith Forum, I would like to thank you all for being here today, and I'd like to remind you to please comply with restrictions, to keep a 2 meter distance at all times, and to please keep your masks on. I'm delighted to welcome Claire on behalf of the Bahá'í Faith, who is going to speak to us about the Festival of Ghazwa. And we'd like to also thank the Lord Mayor for welcoming us to be here today.
Thanks very much, Lua, and I've just taken my mask off to speak. I'd like to thank the Lord Mayor really for inviting us here today, and to greet everybody who's here from the Dublin City Interfaith Forum and our friends. On behalf of the Bahá'í community of Ireland, we're delighted to be here to celebrate the Festival of Ridvan. Now, Ridvan is a festival that Bahá'ís mainly celebrate over a 2 week period, a 12 day period at the end of April, coming into May. So it's a time that we associate here in the Northern Hemisphere really with springtime, nature in bloom, longer days and more light. So I think it's probably safe to say this is the first time we've all celebrated Ridvan in darkest midwinter, but delighted to say that we got a sunny day for it. The writings of the Bahá'í Faith and all the great religions of the world tell us that life is full of both the dark and the light. And the important thing, they tell us, is how we choose to orient ourselves. And that by turning to the light of God's revelation, we can keep ourselves on the right path and find hope and strength, even in very difficult and dark times, such as the ones that we've been living through. So our program today is designed, as all our Holy Day celebrations are designed, to really orient us to the Word of God and help us to turn toward that source of light. Thank you very much for having us here today.
Thank you. are the manifest and the most hidden of the
Ridvan is the holiest and most significant of the festivals of the Bahá'í calendar. Ridvan means paradise and is the name given to those 12 days in 1863 that the founder of the Bahá'í faith, Bahá'u'lláh, and his family spent in Baghdad preparing for the second of their four major exiles from their homeland. Exiles which initially took them from their homeland in Tehran, in modern day Iran, to Baghdad in Iraq, and on to Istanbul in Turkey, and finally to the pestilent prison city of Acre in modern-day Israel. These sequence of exiles and imprisonments at the hands of the religious and civil authorities of Persia, which pushed Bahá'u'lláh and his family ever further from his homeland, were prompted by the implications of his teachings and the majesty and magnetism of his person. Teachings which both the civil and religious leaders of his time found impossible to embrace or tolerate. Teachings such as that the prophets of all faiths come from one divine unknowable essence, that the vision, a vision that the world was one country and all mankind its citizens, his assertion of the equality of both men and women, and a call to the end of extremes of wealth and poverty. Along with these instructions, Bahá'u'lláh offered to humanity the gift of a divinely inspired universal democratic system to enable humanity to bring these spiritual truths into practical reality. But above all these, and perhaps the most significant assertion of Bahá'u'lláh, was that humanity had passed through its stage of childhood and adolescence, was entering humanity, that the age of religious promise was coming to an end, and that the beginning of the fulfillment of those promises had arrived in his person and in his revelation. It was these teachings that brought Bahá'u'lláh, his family and followers to the Garden of Ridvan on the banks of the Tigris in Baghdad in 1863. And it was in this garden that Bahá'u'lláh for the first time publicly declared his station as a manifestation of God, as the promised one foretold by all the world's religions. Of the exact circumstances attending that epoch-making declaration, we are alas but scantily informed. The words Bahá'u'lláh actually uttered on that occasion, the manner of his declaration, the reaction it produced, even the identity of those who were privileged to hear him, are shrouded in an obscurity which future historians will find it difficult to penetrate. The fragmentary description left to posterity by his chronicler Nabil is one of the very few authentic records we possess of the memorable days spent in that garden. Nabil writes, "Every day, near the hour of dawn, gardeners would pick roses which lined the four avenues of the garden and would pile them in the centre of the floor of his blessed tent. So great would be the heat that when his companions gathered to drink their morning tea in his presence, they would be unable to see each other across it. All these roses Baha'u'llah would, with his own hands, entrust to those whom he dismissed from his presence every morning, to be delivered on his behalf to Arab and Persian friends in the city of Baghdad. One night, Nabil continues, the ninth night of the waxing moon, it happened to be one of those who walked beside the blessed tent. As the hour of midnight approached, I saw him issue from his tent, pass by the places where some of his companions were sleeping, and begin to pace up and down the moonlit, flowered bordered avenues of the garden. So loud was the singing of the nightingales on every side that those who were near him could distinctly hear his voice. He continued to walk until pausing in the midst of one of these avenues he observed. Consider these nightingales. So great is their love for these roses that sleepless from dusk till dawn they warble their melodies and commune with burning passion with the object of their adoration. How then can those who claim to be afire with the rose-like beauty of the beloved choose to sleep? For three successive nights I watched and circled round his blessed tent. Every time I passed by his couch where I lay, I would find him wakeful, and every day from morn to even I would see him unceasingly engaging in conversation with the stream of visitors who kept flowing from Baghdad. Baha'u'llah himself has written about this potent and spiritual time. Rejoice with gladness, exceeding gladness, O people of Baha, as ye call to remembrance the day of supreme felicity, the day whereon the tongue of the Ancient of Days hath spoken, as he departed from his house, proceeding to the spot from where he shed upon the whole of creation the splendors of his name, the All-Merciful. Divine springtime is come. The star of blissfulness shineth upon the horizon of our name, the blissful, inasmuch as the kingdom of the name of God has been adorned with the ornaments of the name of thy Lord, the creator of the heavens. At the end of these 12 days, Baha'u'llah and his family and band of companions were escorted from the Garden of Ridvan to make their 1,300-mile journey on foot to Istanbul.
Oh my Lord, oh my Lord, I am a child of tender years. Nourish me in the breast of thy mercy. Train me in the bosom of thy love. Educate me in the school of thy guidance, and develop me under the shadow of thy bounty. Deliver me from darkness. Make me a brilliant light. Free me from unhappiness. Make me a flower of the rose garden. Suffer me to become a servant of thy threshold, and confer upon me the disposition and nature of the righteous. Make me a cause of bounty to the human world, and crown my head with the diadem of eternal life. Verily, thou art the powerful, the mighty, the seer, the healed. Abdu'l-Bahá.
Generous in prosperity and thankful in adversity. Be worthy of the trust of thy neighbor and look upon him with a bright and friendly face. Be a treasure to the poor, an admonisher to the rich, an answerer of the cry of the needy, a preserver of the sanctity of thy pledge. Be fair in thy judgment and guarded in thy speech. Be unjust to no man, and show all meekness to all men. Be as a lamp unto them that walk in darkness, a joy to the sorrowful, a sea for the thirsty, a haven for the distressed, an upholder and defender of the victim of oppression. Let integrity and uprightness distinguish all thy acts. Be a home for the stranger, a balm to the suffering, a tower of strength for the fugitive. Be eyes to the blind, and a guiding light unto the feet of the erring. Be an ornament to the countenance of truth, a crown to the brow of fidelity, a pillar of the temple of righteousness, a breath of life to the body of mankind, an ensign of the hosts of justice, a luminary above the horizon of virtue, a dew to the soil of the human heart, an ark on the ocean of knowledge, a sun in the heaven of bounty, a gem on the diadem of wisdom, a shining light in the firmament of thy generation, a fruit upon the tree of humility.
On their horia, Gerbaha e on Tahendu, Iskerboth e on Jay, Bean of Rullock full of a wina, a comedian Shihon Erbith in a free. Anil Yamut Baha, a horhak she suis, Leganifroch she fin orchard, Alanon, Baha'u'llah.
Thank you. sorry. That's not happening, unfortunately. But next year, maybe, whoever the next Lord Mayor is, I'm hoping the relationship will continue, and I'm hoping we can continue doing this every year. So, because I do think it's necessary that we celebrate diversity and we celebrate inclusion. But to do that, you actually need to show it. You need to have the community around you to show what is happening in the various things. So thank you so much.
Thank you.